In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a pop-up effect in Premiere Pro. Begin by selecting the Type tool and add your text. Then make any adjustments to it in the Properties window, and let's also align it to the center by aligning it horizontally and vertically. Then open Effects window and search for Transform. Then add this effect to the text layer. Then in Effect Controls, if we click on Transform Effect, we will see this anchor point in the center of the text. And this anchor point is where the animation is happening from. So in order to get a proper and even pop-up effect, we need to make sure it stays in the center of the text. Now let's create an animation by moving the time indicator to the start of the text layer. Then under Transform, we're going to create a keyframe for scale by clicking on the stopwatch icon and set the value to 75. Then move 3 frames forward. You can move by using the arrow keys. 1, 2, 3, set the scale to 125, then move 3 frames forward and set the scale to 100. And that gives us a simple pop-up effect that we can make smoother by adding motion blur. So we uncheck, use composition shutter angle, and then increase the shutter angle to 360 to add motion blur. Now everything is looking fine, but let's say you wanted to apply this effect to subtitles that are usually at the bottom of the screen. So let me quickly move the text down. And if I preview this now, the pop-up effect will look very different. You can see the text is getting pushed down. That is because the animation is still happening from the center of the sequence, since that's where the anchor point is located. Now to fix this, we need to move this anchor point down to the center of the text. So we do that by selecting the transform effect, then we click on this anchor point and move it down. As we do that, the text will move up, but that's completely fine, just keep moving it down. Then move the other anchor point as well and align the anchor points with the center of the text. And as I do that, we get our nice pop-up effect back. And at this point, we can easily save this as a preset by right-clicking on the transform effect, select save preset, and give this a name, and make sure you check anchor to in point. This will make sure that the preset is applied consistently regardless of the length of the layer. Then click OK, and now in the presets, you will have the pop-up effect available, so you just drag and drop it onto a different layer.